Do you want to play rough? Okay.
Uno.
Say hello to my little friend.
Throughout the years that Brawl has grown, so has the Legend roster. Every fighting game has its own cast of characters to play as, and Brawlhalla is no exception to this. Brawlhalla brings in a wide variety of different legends that makes it one of the more unique rosters available in fighting games, and also helps with their identity. And while we have a large amount of legends, there are some that we can all agree on that are underrated. With the introduction of Jaehyun, who is the 50th legend to come out, I thought of the idea to create a series that covers and explains these underrated legends and why they may be considered underrated. For this series, I'll be using the Cambridge Dictionary definition of underrated, which is having more importance, value, skill, power, etc. than people recognize. I picked that definition because I feel it heavily applies to the legends that will be discussed. Now we have to look at what classifies a legend as underrated. A legend is classified as underrated because they have a low play rate or representation in the casual and or competitive aspect of Brawlhalla. They are often overlooked or completely forgotten, and people underestimate that legend and no longer like or care about them. Before we actually go into detail of this video's selected legend, I have to point out some disclaimers for the series. If you encounter an underrated legend more than once in a match, or see that character played in competitive, do not automatically discredit some of the points discussed, as you may find some of them to be true. Things are bound to change due to balance patches. An underrated legend may be a legend that everyone plays in the future. And to end the disclaimer, this is all my opinion. You have the right to agree or disagree on some points I cover. Without further ado, let's introduce our legend. The legend we have today is a demon to some, or an angel to others. The legend we have today is one of the coolest gangsters around besides Don Corleone and Giorno, the dealmaker himself, Cross.
So long, Mal. Have a good trip.
Arr.
Cross is a legend with 7 strength, 4 dexterity, 6 defense, and 5 speed. His stats are to reflect that he is meant to be good at killing. Both his weapons have trouble killing on their own, and his defense as well. Defense. Everybody needs it and likes it. Despite his 4 dexterity, it's not a big deal as one would seem. On blasters, not much is offered to blasters if the dexterity is high. However, the number is perhaps different for gauntlet, so let's ask a certified doctor for some insight. Thanks for the insight, Doc. While some may not believe it, 4 dexterity is usable for gauntlets. Perhaps the conception of gauntlets being a string weapon must mean that it needs dexterity in order to be fully utilized. Some weapons and combos need dexterity, others don't. Gauntlets is one that doesn't need that stat. But if you believe you need more dexterity, go ahead, put on that dex stance. With speed stance, it may seem you're playing a dangerous game with 3 dexterity, but just like 4, not a big deal as you think. You also have a chance to win a gold medal in cross country with the additional speed point. Now that's a big win right there. Go ahead, put it on. However, I can't say the same of defense stance. Defense stance is harmful because you are hurting your chances of getting that gold medal, and the stance is somehow trying to make Cross become Barraza with a string weapon. I can't really see this working out well, but we're all built different. If you feel speed isn't a problem and you need high defense, go ahead, put on that stance. Finally, we have strength stance, and more strength is worth it if you are able to kill your opponent faster than they kill you. This stance is the I have to kill them quicker before they kill me stance. Hey, I've seen those stats before. Speaking of killing, something tells me his signatures are a little bit too strong. So yeah, we've got the signatures, and his gauntlet side zig really packs a punch, sending your opponent on a one-way trip while killing at 120 on Brawlhaven. His end zig will send your opponent on a round trip and kills at 120. However, if fully charged, kills at 100. His down sig will take you to the moon and kills at 140. However, if fully charged, it'll kill at 130. While both in sig and down sig are strong, they have their downsides too. In sig charge is affected not only by its damage and force, but by its position to hit, depending on how long you hold it. The longer you hold it, the higher you go. Tapping your heavy key results in cross hitting at a lower point on screen than charging it. Since this move only hits airborne, timing this move while being confident it hits and making sure your opponent doesn't do anything to remain safe from the move, such as jumping away or even fast falling away quickly, can be hard, no matter who you're fighting. D-Sig also relies on the charge, instead sending the move out farther the longer you hold it. Again, this move can be hard to land. The opponent has time to predict it, since it's a long-range move and they might react to it by gaining distance or getting closer or jumping in the air. Not to mention, the move leaves you heavily exposed. Not charging the move all the way could possibly give you time to remain safe, but charging D-Sig leaves you open to many things, and the opponent can get their map control back as well. Blaster N-Sig, like Gauntlet D-Sig, sends them to the moon and kills at 130. Side Sig, with its cool factor, kills at 140, while the charged version kills at 110, and Down Sig kills at 130. While charging the moves don't affect their position or range, D-Sig has an interesting property to it. When both guns go off, one hitbox is slightly higher than the other. You can figure this out by the direction Cross is facing. Whatever direction Cross is facing will cause the one hitbox to be higher than the other. The hitbox height can be the difference between hitting or missing your opponent, in some cases depending on what they do. Oh, you thought I was done? Nah, D-Sig has another interesting property some of y'all don't even realize. Depending on your range, force will be affected differently. Let me explain. So, force is different for Down-Sig if you hit it close up or far away. The far away version does more force than the close up version. I'll demonstrate the far away version versus the close up version. Please note, I've been using base stance cross, my bot is at 5 defense, and the damage is set to 100. As to why the force is different, I don't know. I have no idea. I will say that landing the far away version can be difficult than the close up version. You may not have time or be in a position to land the far away version. The signature is hard to master, not only with its hitboxing, but due to spacing the move and wanting to get the right force for it in case you need to secure a kill. Another thing that can make Cross become or seem underrated is because of his weapon combination. Both gauntlets and blasters are not the easiest weapons to use in the game. It takes time to learn gauntlets and blasters, and using these weapons can be hard, either to utilize or to master. And yes, gauntlets and blasters can be worthwhile to spend time with. However, they both take effort, especially when they're a weapon combination. And if people are given the option to pick something and use effort, or something with no effort, you know which option they're gonna pick most of the time. Let's summarize what makes Cross underrated again. Some of his signatures are challenging to use due to specific properties. Weapon combination can deter players when using Cross. If you play this character, I'm not trying to directly disrespect you. I wanted to share my thoughts on why this character can be seen as underrated. My opinion is my opinion. You can agree with it, disagree with it. You can do whatever you want with it. Who knows what will happen in the future. Maybe we'll get a Fortnite crossover in this game. That'll be the video. Let me know how y'all thought of it. Have a good day.